Hey, good morning everyone. Frank Valkyrie here. Welcome to the channel. Easy, one moment. Woo-hoo. Anyway, today we're going to talk about PewDiePie and why. Well, I'll tell you in a second. Why I want to talk about PewDiePie, first of all, is because it is apparent to me that the media, Vox Media specifically, has taken him again as a target. And of course, we all know what he went through in 2017. And now I don't want to go into details on that. I'm sure he regrets a lot of the things and a lot of the jokes that he made, specifically those which caused the controversy. And in his defense, I have to say, when you are a comedian, because after all, PewDiePie has his own brand of comedian of comedy, he's a comedian and he's producing comedic content on this platform. So you always have to keep that in mind. But of course, when you are that kind of comedian, you're always trying to get a reaction from people, provoke, and you always have to be careful. You're always walking like on the edge. You know, like, and when you push too far, sometimes you cannot go back, and that's how you get burned. Now he was again into a sort of controversy because he was giving shout outs to smaller creators which they helped him with this whole thing, this series against PewDiePie and so on and so forth. And by giving this shout out, he didn't realize that some of the people or one person that was part of this big group, bigger group of creators, let's say, questionable content on his page, which probably seems to lean a little bit on the right, too much on the right. So, the right, the other right. So, of course, in his defense, I don't think that he had to go through and he went through double-checking all of the people, of course, so you can make that kind of mistake, but he's already distanciated himself from that. But the media doesn't care, of course, Vox doesn't care, so they immediately jump in to the truth. Because, in my opinion, what I think they have in mind is the fact that PewDiePie is a very influential creator. I mean, just to give you a little bit of context, nowadays I think The Tonight Show, which is one of the historical show on American TV, it probably averages around 3 million views for episode, or around there, 2-3 million views, more or less, so, which is a lot. In the past used to be more because, of course, more people watch TV. But an average episode of PewDiePie easily can surpass 3 million views. And just to give you an example, this song, Bitch Lasagna, has already passed, I think, 70 million, which is incredible. It's incredible. I mean, if you think about it, that the last episode of Seinfeld, which is probably historically the biggest TV show ever, or at least at the time that people watched, I think the last episode was watched by 76 million people. And that alone makes you realize how much influence PewDiePie has. And also in this landscape of the world nowadays, where most of the advertisement has shifted from printed magazines, which before used to print the ads, which you open and you watched when you were reading and you were drinking coffee. People still do that, but in the past, of course, they printed so many more magazines compared to today, and everything has moved on the internet, and also most of the advertisement is going through Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. So smaller companies, they're having a hard time. They're really having an hard time just, probably getting at the end of the month or something. So in a way, it's obvious that they're going to go after an individual that holds so much influence, because by undermining him and the platform where he's producing content, because I also read an article which they blamed YouTube, or, you know, they're targeting YouTube as well, blaming YouTube on why PewDiePie is still there, if it's an anti-Semitic and blah 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 blah. So they're targeting both him and the platform because they are trying desperately to take away some of that power. For me, personally, as an individual, I care about saving PewDiePie for as long as he continues to be dishonest not dishonest, but honest like this, honest about the content he produces, and more open and clear, and he stays away from controversial things, which by now I think he probably has learned himself to try to stay away from certain kind of comedy. But for me, it's important to save him metaphorically. Of course, he doesn't need my help. I'm a small creator. I'm an emerging creator, so to speak. But because he represents us, creators, smaller creators as well. He went through that whole process, and as an individual, he managed to create success on this platform with this brand of comedy. And for us, creators, artists, musicians, actors, whatever, comedians, which they are looking to achieve the same objective, it's important to preserve his freedom of speech and his ability to be a content creators and the platform itself. So of course the community takes care of itself, and by that I mean you can see that already with the fan base of PewDiePie, which the people that know him, of course, they stand by his side, and he still has, you know, he hasn't lost any subscribers or whatever, because all the defamation and misrepresentation from the media is not working. It's not working because we can see, the fan can see, that he's a good guy doing comedy. And of course, also when you are an individual alone, when you don't compare yourself with a lot of other professional comedians around you, which they write for you, whatever, sometimes you can make a full step, but you learn. You learn, and hopefully he has learned. So, but it's important. It's so incredibly important that we keep this platform free. We keep this platform free because this platform represents that democratic process which validates the effort of the people puts into something. And this is something beautiful. This is something we have to preserve together with freedom of speech, because this is the first time. Now we give it for granted, you know, the new generation which started to use YouTube when they were 9 or 10, and now they're older, they give this for granted. Now they're in their 20s, but it wasn't always like this, you know? You couldn't just be a creator, sitting in front of a camera with two lights, share your thoughts, and perhaps get an audience to listen to you. And maybe even make a few bucks out of it. That's extraordinary. This was a privilege only relegated to studios with big budgets and a presenter and people working around and a cameraman and so on and so forth and a director, which is still the case. But today you can do the same. And you can make a lot of money, like, you know, creators like PewDiePie does or Casey Neistat or whatever, which is unprecedented. And of course, we as a community, we have to stand together because we make this platform. So we have to manage to keep this platform free, with some guidelines, but free. And since also it's the first time we are doing this, we also don't know where it's gonna lead. So we have to be careful and we have to be sharp. We have to be here together to move towards the future, to make sure that this type of platforms like YouTube, they don't become just another TV, but they evolve into something perhaps potentially better. Because if it becomes just another type of TV, like TV used to be in the 80s, then it's just we are just shifting from one thing to another. But it's important to envision how we have to move forward, both as the people owning this platform, creating this platform, keeping this platform up, and us, that we provide some entertainment and we create the community, bigger or smaller, we create the community, and this, you know, like that makes this platform exist. I look forward personally to see YouTube finding ways of not censoring us, finding ways to retribute us, finding ways to promote and support the people which make this platform great and growing, and also not forget about the plethora of all the other smaller creators which they make this incredible community. And we have to stand strong, we have to keep growing, and know why you do this, and always spread love. And I'll see you next time. You take care.